men going their own way are wrecking the economy.
You know, my brother was telling me about how in the gym, guys don't really approach girls, which, good. Don't approach me. Don't talk to me. Thank you. But so then, I was like, if we're supposed to approach guys, how do you know?
Men going their own way are wrecking the economy. Women said to men, don't speak to us, don't approach us, don't talk to us, look the other way. In fact, don't even come and walk in the same direction as us. And men listen, and now they're complaining because they don't know how to respond to this. They no longer know how to communicate with men if they told all the men to go away. They listen to their feelings, and now their feelings have betrayed them. Watch to the end of the video to fully understand what the implications of MGTOW are, men going their own way, and how them leaving the economy and walking away from the economy is resulting in serious devastation to the economic landscape and the lives of women. And now let's just go ahead and jump into the first video.
All right, what's up, TikTok? Emergency breaking news. The stock markets are crashing. This is information, educational. This is all facts, okay? It is 8/5/2024, August 5th, 2024. It is a Monday, and overnight, it was daytime in Japan and South Korea, but their markets started to collapse, and they had to shut their markets down. Now, in the United States, now that the markets are open, $2 trillion out within the first hour of the markets being open. Black Monday? Yeah, here it is. All of the trade brokers, apps down. They're shutting them down. They're not letting you trade. So institutions can trade, but the private people can trade. Crypto is going down. We told you all this would happen right before election season, right before interest cuts. All of this was going to happen. And when they cut interest rates, it's just going to hyperinflate everything. And so Japan's economy is in the gutter. They hold U.S. Treasury bonds. They're the number one holder of U.S. Treasury bonds. So they're going to start dumping their treasury bonds, which is going to hyperinflate our economy. And everything is still tied to the world reserve currency, the U.S. dollar. That's what they've been changing. That's what they've been working on with BRICS to de-dollarize. Everything that has been happening over the last, well, it's been going on for decades, but everything since 2020 has been systematically a domino to get ready for this.
When a guy wants to be approached by a girl, you know? Like, because girls, we'll give, like, the little ojitos, we'll give little signs. But, you know, it'll be like, we'll keep looking back. They're like, ah. But how do you know? Like, if you're a guy and you saw a pretty girl and you wanted her to talk to you because you don't want to talk to her, what do you do?
See, here's the very interesting thing, guys. Women said that don't approach us, don't speak to us, don't look in our direction. If a man does not feel comfortable approaching this woman, if this woman does not want the man to approach her, why in the world would he want her to approach him? If she's the type of person that is nasty, mean-spirited, and is like, don't come anywhere near me, or I will M2 you, shame you, destroy your life, say that you're a creep, but it's okay if I want to approach you, why would he want you to approach them? Of course, women cannot process this kind of concept because, you know, they can't understand normal thinking. Everything based around the way that they think is entirely based around feeling. So they choose the feelings that they like. It's not based on facts. It's not based on reasoning based around facts. It's based on reasoning based around feelings, which means they choose the feelings that make them feel the best, that they agree with, that they like the best. It's not rooted in reality. It's rooted in the reality that they choose to accept. It's an insane way of living and viewing the world around you. And that's the reason why when women make these choices and they end up, you know, with lives that are destroyed, it's only after their lives have been destroyed. It's only after they've scorched the earth and they're left with nothing and left with devastation that they then turn around and say, okay, well, now I'm going to look at the facts. Okay, my feelings betrayed me. I'm going to look at the facts. I screwed up. I destroyed everything around me. And that's really all that it is. And they're grieving because they destroyed their lives, but at the same time, they're like, yeah, there's nothing I can really do about it because I operate based on feelings over facts. So, you know, and I choose the facts that I want to agree with. Even when women try to use facts, they're only going to choose the facts that they feel the best about. Not the facts that makes more sense, not the facts that are rooted most deeply in reality, but the facts that they like the best. Because there's many different facts, and there are different ways to manipulate facts, you know, to manipulate statistics. And that's what women have done for a long time, to get the results that they want, even if they don't, if they're not rooted in reality. They'll make things that are not reality the reality so that they can say that's the reality, even if it's not true. That's the way that women operate. And you can't change it. There's no way to change it. There's a lot of guys, and I try to explain this concept that the male brain and the female brain is different. And a lot of men cannot comprehend this concept. They don't care, which is one of the reasons why I say, like, you know, guys are like, no, women can do this. They can. No, they really can't. They can try, but they don't think the way that we think. You're letting them off the hook angry. I'm not letting them off the hook. What I'm trying to illustrate to you is their brain chemistry is not the same. They are always going to deviate towards their feelings. They can try to use facts. They can try to use reason, but they are biologically wired to choose to reason and choose facts and facts over feelings, or choose the facts that make them feel the best. And again, so a lot of men refuse to accept this concept. They're like, you know, when they're like, okay, no, you know, if things go wrong, well, women are going to have to, you know, submit and obey the man and all this other stuff. And I'm like, again, women will always do what they choose to do. Women will always do what they want to do. They are not your property, okay? And a lot of men refuse to accept this. And then when their lives get destroyed, they want to come back and cry on me. And it's like, no, you chose to go down this road. You chose to. You chose these. You made these decisions yourself. You chose this. You would refuse to understand reality. I presented the facts to you, but then you got lost in your feelings because you refused to accept that women and men and women are not the same, all right? Or you cannot turn a woman into something that you want them to be. A lot of men were fed the whole Disney princess garbage where they would, with Beauty and the Beast. It's all trash. It's all nonsense. It's all lies. But so many guys, they want the lie. They want the fantasy that they would prefer to avoid accepting reality. And when they get screwed, they want to come back to Uncle Angry and say, Uncle Angry, I got screwed. I need a moment of your time. And I'm like, no, dipsit. I'm not going to give you a moment of my time. You chose to go out there. You did not listen to me. All right. You wanted to be your own big man. And this is what happened. You don't care about men. I don't care about men. I spent all of my time sharing the knowledge, telling you exactly how it is. I said, I can't tell you what to do, but don't do this. You went out there, you got screwed, and you know, now you want to come back to me and cry on me. Like, how crazy do you have to be? This is why so many men turn their backs on other men, because a lot of men don't want to listen, all right? I'm a man who didn't want to listen. I paid the ultimate price. At least I'm still here. Well, I shouldn't say the ultimate price. Let me tell you something, guys. There are things worse than death in this world, all right? I've paid some grave prices. There are some men who paid worse prices than me. All right, guys, compared to what I'm going through, it's lightweight compared to what some men are going through and have gone through over the course of decades. There are men who've lost hundreds of thousands of dollars, and that's nothing compared to some other men who've lost millions of dollars as a result of not learning their lesson, all right? Not learning their lessons. So at least, so to some degree, I got off easy. The worst thing that can happen to me is I can die. All right. There are things worse than death. Children, there are things worse than death in this world. Many of you don't understand that. There are things worse than death. It's only when you have suffered, truly suffered, you will understand there are things worse than dying. You can suffer in ways that you can never, ever imagine. There are things much worse than death. Death is not the worst thing that can happen to you in this world. It's one of the simplest, the gentlest, if done right. Okay? Now, suffering. Oh, suffering, suffering, suffering. I tell you, there are ways you can suffer that you would never even imagine possible. There's an unimaginable suffering that exists. All right? From spiritually, socially, mentally, financially, economically, in ways that we haven't even invented yet. Oh, you can suffer. It will feel like you are suffering for an eternity. And suffering can even be compounded, like interest. Men going their own way are wrecking the economy. You're seeing that as men are walking away, women have nothing to turn to, no one to turn to, other than, you know, the state and the states, the relationship with women in the state is this. Women operate as agents for the state and they are rewarded with wealth and resources for men. So by as a reward for reallocating wealth and resources from men, you know, to the state through the civil court system, through the court system. So through civil court, through family court, through divorce court, through criminal court, women are rewarded and they're given assets. They're given a cut of those assets. But if, you know, a share of resources, but if women are not performing their task as agents of the state, then what they will receive will be reduced. If they are not becoming single mothers and then allowing the state to reallocate wealth and resources that way, they're not going to get a cut, you know, or their cut will be reduced. You know, it's only going to get worse and worse and worse. And women believe that they have power when in reality, it's just privilege. They believe they have rights when it's really just special privileges. And privileges can be taken away. The Constitution is not a bill of, you know, the Bill of Rights from the Constitution. That's not a Bill of Rights. That's a Bill of Privileges. George Carlin said it. Read it very, very carefully. They can be taken away from you at any time. He warned us about the state. He warned us about the boomers, all right? He told us who the boomers were. He was a member of the Silent Generation. He told us who the boomers were. He said they are not like previous generations. They are cold, so bloodless people. They are soulless people. That's what George Carlin said about them, all right? They are greedy. They want all of the toys for themselves, and they're going to get it. That's what he said that about the boomers. He warned us about the boomers, all right? He said they have no empathy for any other one, for anyone else, all right? They don't care about anyone else. This was like 20, 30 years ago. 20, 30 years ago, he warned us about those people. Men are done with the state. Men are done with relationships. And you're watching it now. You're watching MGTOW, all right? Not even MWA, MGTOW, all right? Men going their own way who are walking away from society and relationships in society. If a man does not have love for family or for country, he will fight for neither. And there's nothing there. And the more you try to tax men, the worse the outcome, because men will just reduce their tax liability, okay? You can never make a man, you can never force a man to work harder than he will work, than he will force himself to work. All right? It's 100% true. If you force a man, push a man on a plantation, and you'll break his spirit. You'll break his spirit. And you'll basically just assign a certain amount of work and you'll work him to death. You'll work him to death, and that's it. If a man has nothing inside of him, he will, guys. You know, they talk about, I read a book, and I remember it was written by an author. I think he was a doctor, and he was, if you go back 50 years ago, we all know what happened with the guy with the funny mustache, and some people were forced to stay in camps, you know, back in overseas, and we all, you know, some people wrote stories about this, and there was a guy who was a doctor, and he was in one of these camps, and he said, you always could tell the people who were going to die, because they would suddenly lose faith in the future and they would stop talking about their families and stop talking about their dreams and what they're going to do. And once they had no vision of the future, that was it. They would pass away shortly after that. And these men who no longer have dreams or aspirations, a lot of these guys, they're just going to watch society burn. And if you try to torment them, try to torture them, send them overseas to go fight battles that they don't want to fight, if they have no soul to fight, if they're not fighting for family back home, if they're not fighting for country, they're just slaves. Can you imagine gathering up a bunch of slaves, telling them that they're not slaves? It's an honor to fight and die for the country that is enslaving you. You're privileged to be, you're a slave, and you're being told that you're privileged. You are privileged. You are the most privileged in the world. Now go give your life. Guys, you've got to be kidding me. All right? The future is destitution, poverty, you know, homelessness for a lot of these individuals who said they did not want us and now they need us. There's a lot of destitution. There's not going to be anything left. All right? And men are just going to watch it all burn. That's where it's all leading. That's where it's all heading. The economy, men pay 80% of all taxes. I mean, women make 80% of all consumer purchases. Men are no longer going to be paying these crazy taxes. They're going to make just enough money to survive and thrive and no more. And women are not going to be able to make these purchases anymore. The economy is going downhill. The government can't even pay its interest on all of its debt. $35 trillion in debt. Government cannot pay its interest on that. Guys, subscribe to our newsletter for my personal thoughts, insights, and a free copy of my ebook, The Blueprint for Escaping the Rat Race. Click the link in the description to get your free copy. What do you guys think regarding all of this? All right, men going your own way are wrecking the economy. Let me know your thoughts, and we'll talk about it in the comments. Like the video if you like it. Don't forget to subscribe. And if you like the video, share the video. And just remember that all roads lead to MWA, men walking away. And cheers.